Hi, and welcome back to my ExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to use multiple criteria in the VLOOKUP function. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
Has this ever happened to you? Have you ever been working in a spreadsheet trying to use the VLOOKUP formula, and when you get to the criteria argument, you would like to use more than one variable for your criteria? So normally, I would look up Tom, and I would return a value. But in this case, I want to look up Tom in column A under my sales rep, and South in column B under my region. And then I want to return whatever the amount is in the sales column. So how do I go about doing that? Well, there's a few different ways you can do this, but the way we're going to go over today is what we are going to refer to as a helper column. So I'm going to select column A, right click, and go to insert. And let's call this helper. And then in A2, I'm going to type a formula. And that formula is going to look like this. I'm going to say equals, and then I'm going to click on B2, type an ampersand, and then click on C2 and hit enter. And right here, you can see that essentially all I did was put together the value that was here and here into one cell. So if I select this cell, and if you can see this square right here at the bottom right-hand corner of my cell, if I hover my mouse till I get this cross-like mouse and double-click, I can fill this formula all the way down to the end of my data range. Also, if I hover my mouse between column A and B, I will get this cross-like cursor again. Once I have that, if I double-click, I can make my column wider to fit the widest cell that I have selected.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Okay, so now that I've put these two values together into one cell, that is also called concatenation, let's go over here in cell G3 and put in our VLOOKUP formula. So now I'm going to type equals VLOOKUP in a left parenthesis. Now, what value am I going to want to look up? Well, just like we concatenated our cells together over here, we can also concatenate our two cells that we have right here. So let's click on G1, again put an ampersand, and then click on G2. So that's the value that we want to look up, these two cells together. Then I'm going to type a comma, and I'm going to come back here and just select my whole table area. And I can just click on column A and drag all the way over to column D. And then I'm going to type a comma. And my last argument here is going to be, what column index do I want? So remember, we're using a VLOOKUP. A is column 1, B is column 2, C is column 3, and D is column 4. So in this case, I want to type a 4 and then a comma. And for my range lookup, I usually want to type a 0 here or select false, which is an exact match. And then if I put a parenthesis and I hit enter, I can see that Tom in South is 81,747. And if I look over here for Tom in South, I can see that this value is 81,747. But I also have Tom North at 21,000. So let's see if I just go up to my region and I change this to North and hit enter. I can now see that my VLOOKUP function is finding Tom North right now at 21,473. So this is one way that you can use multiple criteria inside of the VLOOKUP function. Feel free to check out our blog for some other options on using multiple criteria. I'll include the link to the blog in the description below. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.